Hi, welcome to Think Human. I'm Chris, and in this video I want to do something a little bit different. So I was looking around our wonderful science community on Facebook, and I saw a lot of interesting and mind-boggling ideas and interesting thoughts and questions, and I thought it would be fun to respond to a few of these questions and statements. And so I printed out a few pages, and so let's go. Is there life after death? Whoa! Question mark, question mark, question mark. We just don't know, man, at the moment. We just don't know. It's too easy to say that there isn't from a scientific mindset, but truth be told, we just don't know what the nature of consciousness is, and reality is profoundly strange, probably stranger than we can imagine, so just don't know. Hey guys, I'm wondering if any of you guys have bought this lamp from the site below. I'm thinking of buying the lamp from a girlfriend. If anyone has bought this thing, let me know if it's worth the $14. Please send me video for physical science. What kind of video? Aliens, is there in the universe? That's a good question. I've thought many times, aliens, is there in the universe? True answer would be that biologists would say that it's really difficult to get life, and the chances of having life are probably small and really complicated to get life. Astrophysicists, on the other hand, look at the vastness of the universe that we live in, how many billions of galaxies, billions of stars we have. So there must be life in this infinite ocean that we are floating in. So it would be really strange if we were the only ones. So quite possibly, yes, but we just don't know. We haven't found any proof for that yet. Just an idiot's question, but curious. Is it possible for a planet to be bigger than our sun? Or is there a possibility that there is an even bigger sun than what we have? Interesting question. So a planet can't really be bigger than our sun, because if a planet is bigger than our sun, then it becomes a sun. Stars work like sun is a star, and all stars work in a way that they just have so much mass that that mass collapses and generates so much pressure and temperature that the star starts the process of nuclear fusion, and that produces even more energy, pressure and light, and then we have stars. So if you have some bunch of mass that's heavier than our sun, bigger than a sun, then it's definitely a star. Is there a possibility that there's an even bigger sun than what we have? Definitely, there are way bigger stars, mind-numbingly huge stars out there. Based on my own knowledge, sun is a star, yes, a large one, which creates a disc-like thingy which turns out our galaxy. It's kind of like how a star is about to explode. It's kind of similar to our galaxy. Do you mean the solar system and the galaxy? That's interesting. It's easy to question now. Well, then, is there a planet bigger than our sun? Yes. Is there a sun bigger than what we have somewhere in space? Yes, I think that's the same question. Our galaxy is kind of similar to how a star is about to explode. Is it based on what I remember from the documentary I watched? All my knowledge I got from this one documentary, as much as it has everything in it. If so, will our galaxy be like that someday? So the galaxy doesn't explode, if that's what you're asking. I'm not sure what you mean. As much as I remember from that documentary, that one documentary had everything in it, it's possible that star could either become a black hole or a planet. So, interesting question. Like, it's so sweet, like, you know, having this curiosity, which is so cool, and absolutely awesome that you're asking these questions. You have a lot to learn, really do, but it's awesome, and first step to being awesome is to have questions about the world, and curiosity is awesome. So star can become a black hole. A planet, no. A star is already so massive that, you know, it's past the point of being a planet. A black hole it could become. If a star is more massive than about 3 times the mass of our sun, at the end of its life, when it stops burning fuel, so there's no pressure pushing the star outwards to keep it alive, then the star starts collapsing. And then when it's more massive than the sun, a lot more massive, then it collapses into a black hole. This region of space that is incredibly bizarre and has so high density and gravity that nothing can escape it, not even light. That's why it's called a black hole. So those were the questions. Really cute, sweet. I hope this was something. I hope you see this video. I'll send it to you. How much time it will take to reach the end of the universe? Also a really interesting question. So long time. So the stars all burn out. The only stars remaining, paradoxically, in a funny way, the smallest stars, red dwarfs, are actually the ones that will stay alive longer than any of the bigger stars. Bigger stars burn off their fuel much more quickly and then explode. Small stars have this convection cycle where they recycle all their fuel and everything gets equally distributed inside, so they burn for trillions of years, longer than our universe has been existing right now. Eventually, they will also die, and the last things to fade away in the universe are black holes, and they will exist for incredibly long periods of time, longer than anything else by orders of magnitude. But at the end, even black holes will evaporate away due to Hawking radiation, and what we're left with is a universe that's getting colder and more uniform and full of just particles, and we're really not certain what will happen. What is life is all about. Wow, that's deep. I wonder that too. I think it's like what you make of it, you know. I was looking for a concrete sort of objective meaning to life as well, like what is all about, you know, asking that. But there's nothing really. If you get deep into it and learn about the world and stuff, there's nothing. There is, however, what you make, and with time and wisdom, we realize that that's the only thing that really matters. What meaning we give it to our lives and our existence. It's all up to us. And some people, it's depressing, but it really isn't. It should liberate and give tremendous amounts of freedom in the world that we actually are free beings. Hi guys, it's nice being with y'all. Hi guys, it's nice being with y'all. How do I measure time and space, please? I need to know. So time, you have like a stopwatch, and space, you have like a ruler. I don't know. Well, new to this forum, looking forward to learning. Also appreciate and hope this is one filters out pseudoscience, not cases and whack, not conspiracies. I hope to learn from you all, purely science and science theory based perspectives. So says this science layman. Oh, that's sweet. Yeah, we do our best, but it's difficult to keep pseudoscience at bay. People are just so attracted to pseudoscience, and a lot of the mods, I suspect, even can't tell the difference either. I mean, we're all just people. It is clearly known that the Big Bang theory works in verifying the truth, hence about 88% of the earth mineral are in space. I didn't know that. It's clearly known that the Big Bang theory works in verifying the truth, hence about 88% of the earth mineral are in space. How do you get from Big Bang theory working and being the truth, verifying the truth, and that means that about 88% of the earth minerals are in space? Huh? What keeps the planets in our solar system constantly orbiting in the same position after every evolution? Gravity. Yeah, like in the, it's a good question. In the vacuum of space, there is nothing to slow down. Like in Earth, in the atmosphere that we live in, we have air drag, and that slows things down tremendously. If you don't have that, like in the vacuum of space, there is nothing preventing objects from moving and nothing to stop them. What is time? So that's an interesting question. Time, the only reason we have experienced time is because of a process called entropy, and entropy is the measure of disorder. Yesterday, entropy was lower than today. We know that because entropy before that day was even lower. Entropy is the measure of things being organized. So the Big Bang was really organized, really low entropy state, and ever since the Big Bang, with every single second, a fraction of a second, and day and month and year, the entropy of the universe has been increasing. It's the idea that there are way many more ways of things being disordered than things actually being ordered, and that's the only thing that we know as entropy, time. Laws of physics, everything, like, work perfectly equally in the same way if you go forwards or backwards in time. In fact, they require no time, really. But the only thing it is entropy, and that's a long discussion, and I would suggest looking up entropy. It's really interesting stuff. Where is the direction of energy? Depends what energy do you mean. What is the function of the adrenal glands? Well, the adrenal gland produces adrenaline. Is the theory related to heat death of the universe correct? That's a good question. So heat death of the universe, basically what we talked about briefly before, is that eventually everything will just get cold and uniform, and that's one of the hypothetical ends to the universe, that everything will just heat death, everything will just cool down and sort of become a soup of just particles really spread apart over vast distances. And yeah, I am surrounded by people who don't share the same interests as me. What should I do while I have scientific curiosity? Oh, that's sweet. So that's a struggle I've had a lot. You know, the more you educate and learn, the more different and a bit alienated you can become from other people, and you realize that other people don't really care, not interested in scientific stuff. And it's a struggle even now. I have maybe few friends who I can talk about that kind of stuff, but not really on the level that I would want to. So that's the online community. That's why I'm making my YouTube channel, to kind of express and to think and to talk about this kind of stuff, because I have a hunger for that, and I know that many, many other people too. So I would just say, you know, be happy if you're smart, and you know, keep learning and live life, and you will meet awesome people who are also interested in science. Imagine what would happen if you took the supercomputers the NSA uses for data collection and instead gave them to NASA or Elon Musk to help plot the universe and the approximate coordinates of the Big Bang. Dude, that's unimaginable. I can't imagine that. Is whole universe made up of waves? Brilliant question. Yeah, like pretty much. At least all the stuff is. All the stars, planets, people, galaxies, quasars, black holes is waves, yeah. So all particles fundamentally are waves. The particles are just a weird way of how we perceive, you know, light or electrons or stuff to be, but it's all waves actually. So the whole universe, everything, all the stuff is just vibrations in fields, different kind of fields, and this is how we get everything around us. Hello, hello. I'm very intrigued by this. Did he use sound vibration to levitate these rocks? If so, how was this possible, and why don't we have this technology today? Ancientexplorers.com. Coral Castle. How a stick man used ancient wisdom. The Coral Castle of Homestead, Florida. I'm very intrigued by this. I believe you are. This is the kind of pseudoscience stuff, you know. It's a good question that you ask, like, if so, how was this possible, and why don't we have this technology today? We'll work back from that and think about, well, if it's nowhere to be found and this one guy says that it's possible, like some kind of doubt should emerge in your mind. You know, question that, question everything, you know, do that. So, damn, this was a long video. So, just response to some interesting comments and thoughts that I found. I hope it was interesting to watch in some way. If you have any thoughts, please share them in the comments. And of course, thank you so much for watching, and take care.